So my father, Toshikato, he came to the U.S. in the early 70s. What I heard was he kind of like ran away from his house. He wanted to, you know, run away from his parents and he wanted to start a new life. So that's what made him bring himself to the U.S. And then he first went to Hawaii and then to San Francisco. So, and then he went to, and then he started his life in San Francisco. He went to school and then he met my mom in the U.S. And then they got married and then I was born. He liked building stuff. He liked to make stuff. And he loved making taiko drums as a hobby.
Is it 15 years now?
He quit his job and he became a taiko maker. He wanted to make that his job. And he did that at home up north in Northern California, where my parents' house is. But ever since we opened this facility in 2013, he moved at the same time. And then we started working together in the same facility.
So this work is kind of endless. Yeah, usually 7 days a week, 10 hours, uh-huh. So yeah, I need a rest and getting older.
My dad makes American taiko, so all of his drums are made from wine barrels, but Asano taiko makes drums from like solid piece of wood.
Hop, don, don, ka, da, ka, ka, sut, don, ha. Don, don, hop, don, don, ka, da, ka, ka, sut. The thing that inspired me at the beginning was the way that it's half music and half dance. I remember just loving the physicality of it. There aren't too many instruments that can survive the energy of the whole body. You know, you can't smash a violin with your whole body, you know? That to me feels like, I don't know, that feels like a right thing in our current day and age. It's like a really hopeful idea that you could spend a lifetime, or you could spend hours and hours and hours in one place trying to be yourself, trying to learn techniques like turning knobs and patching stuff and trying to figure out like, what do I like? And that someday that is going to be what makes you special to other people and then connects you to other people. You know what I mean? There's like a leap of faith when you're in the studio and I'm just practicing some stupid technique. It's not on its own worth anything. You know, like I can play fast, but who cares if you can play fast? Until that moment when someone says, can you play this faster? And you can say, yes. And it's like, oh, it's worth it. It's all that time, all that work on trying to be a better musician is just for the purpose that someday, hopefully, will connect you to people.
I love this instrument because there's so much possibilities and you can do so many things with even a little setup. And it's like the same way with when you get together with people, you know, and make music. Like, for example, if I connect this machine to this one, it will make this machine do something that it hasn't done before, you know. And if I connect this guy with this guy, with the same guy, it will do something different, which is kind of the same thing that when we get together and play music, you know, each musician influences the other one in a way that is unique, you know.
Yeah! Awesome. Okay, let's go to the next one.
The first real ensemble that we think of in Japan was started by a guy that played jazz drums. So, yeah, so the music and just this whole concept, that's like as new as music gets. But then the instruments are so old. And the, you know, we usually credit gagaku, which includes these instruments, like we're looking at them now, basically exactly the same. Gagaku is like the first orchestral music in the world. It's about 800 years old, and that tradition, it's incredible. So these drums have this insanely old roots and then this ridiculously brand new concept. And it's just like, as performers, we just decide where on that spectrum are we going to be. I study shamisen, which is very much like I'm just trying to understand my teacher and trying to fit myself into that mold. Jack Bazar is very much the other side. Like, what does it mean for me to play this drum, and how do I want to move? I'm good with anywhere along that spectrum. It's fun to bounce through it, you know? My music, like Jack Bazar, was, you know, it was not like what existed before. Yeah, the choreography is definitely weird by taiko standards.
Like reverb, but inside the drum,
right?
Like a spring reverb,
right? Now it turns out we have an Odaiko world champion here in the room with us.
You know, people or everybody needs something that they can be like really passionate about, you know, and that could be cooking, or it could be martial arts, or it could be, you know, it could be anything. And for me, it just happens to be taiko. I think it probably helps that I've done this since I was very little. And I think a huge part of it definitely has to do with being a part of a society or being part of a group of people. His name is Mr. Yoichi Watanabe, and he's kind of the one that taught me from when I was 7 or 8 to 29.
Okay, wow.
So he's like a second father to me, or I'll call him my father of music, because he taught me not only about taiko technique, but also about how to kind of approach the path of being a musician.
like that, that would sound really good.
I mean, like, it's the thing I want to be doing most. You know, I was excited to work with Juan. And anybody that's, like, wanting to try things with Taiko, that's exactly what I want to be doing. Yeah, Taiko is, I think, when we start to think outside of the standards, we actually get closer to what the instruments want. Like, Taiko is not Japanese. That's just like a box that we drew around it at some point. But these drums were in China before that, and they were in India before that, and they were in Africa before that. So it's just that at some point, we like drew a box and we said Japanese. But then it turns out that these are also influenced by, you know, North American music, by jazz and by hip hop. So it's like, it is a mix. Like, everything is just, it's humanity. And so it's this crazy mixture. And I think once we let ourselves go with what we love, that sound is beautiful, that sound is beautiful, how do I use them? I think that actually gets you closer to what real taiko is, real electronics. It's just love. It's just letting yourself go places where you like, you know? I think that's a very honoring thing. It's just to love things and put them together and give them.
I think music is the only universal language. It doesn't really matter where you come from, what race or religion you are, because at the end of the day, music has no boundaries and really connects us all. We are living in a particular time in history that we need to respect and understand each other more than ever. So for me, Wire Sessions, it's of course about the music, but it's also about getting together, experience each other culture, and you know, at the end of the day, have fun.